Hello, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I'll be talking about Remix and how it works under the hood. So without further ado, let's just jump into it.
Alright, so you'll probably agree with me, but the best place to start whenever you're dealing with a new framework, a new package, a new plugin, a new whatever, is the documentation. So if we go to the documentation, we can find introduction and technical explanation of what Remix is. So the compiler part we're gonna skip, and we're gonna jump into the HTTP handler and adapters part. So for this part, I prepared an example for you, and we're gonna jump right into it. But first, let me explain a few things. So what's important to note here is that Remix is built on top of the WebFetch API. And why this is important is because it's easier to use it anywhere because it's built on top of this. Because, for example, if it was built on top of Node, it would probably have some Node-specific bindings that wouldn't work in, for example, Dino. But because it's built on top of standards that are used everywhere and are cross-compatible in different environments, this means that Remix can pretty much run anywhere where Fetch is supported, which means it can run on Vercel, Netlify, Cloudflare, Dino, wherever. As long as it runs a JavaScript server, you're good to go. So if you look at the example for Express, we can see that the server is given the Remix create request handler, and this allows us to handle requests. So in essence, Remix is a request handler that can be plugged into anywhere with the correct adapter. And how it works is basically you get the request, you transform it for Remix, you give it to Remix, Remix gives you a response, you return the transformed response back, and you're good to go. And let's just jump into the example before we continue any further and show you how it's done. Alright, so I prepared this example to show you how exactly it works. So if you look at this here, this is our Node.js server. So this can be anything, but for the sake of the example, I'm going with Node because it's the most, it's the simplest one. And let's say we have a bunch of incoming requests to the server and we want to handle them. So traditionally how this works is, let's say you send the request and this Node server is gonna handle it. So it's probably going to validate it, do something with the data that you sent, and then send back a response. So in this part is where Remix comes in. So what Remix does is basically it's a request handler that's going to get the request that came in, do something with it, and give you the response. So how it works is you build an adapter for Remix, and most of the popular servers out there already have adapters like Express, like Dino, whatever. And what's gonna happen is you're gonna send all of the requests that are coming in to Remix. And what's Remix gonna do is say, okay, I'm gonna use this request that you transformed into the WebFetch API request. So the WebFetch API request, you can find the documentation on MDN. So basically that's the web standard way of doing fetch requests, and you can look at the documentation for requests and for responses. And how it works is you use the request, you transform it with the adapter to the WebFetch API request object, and then you give it to Remix. And then what Remix does is it's going to server-side render your React code, and then it's going to give you a response. So then after that, the adapter is going to take this WebFetch API response object, and then it's going to turn it into the response object that the Node server wants, or whatever else you're running it in. And then it's going to respond from the server back to wherever the request came in from. So what this means for us is basically that you can run Remix anywhere. So all you need to do is create an adapter. The adapter handles the transformation of the incoming request to the WebFetch API request, and then handles the response from Remix and turns it into the response for the server that you're running in. So what this means is basically if you have an adapter for Cloudflare, you just plug it in and Remix is gonna work with it. If you have an adapter for Hono, for Alicia, for whatever, you just plug it in and it works. And that's why it's so easy to get Remix to work anywhere and run it anywhere, because it's really easy to plug it in anywhere, because it's not a custom server that has its own constraints. It's rather a request handler that handles your requests and sends back responses to the client. And what's cool about this is that it basically means that if you want to replace Node.js with something else, let's say you want to run a Hono server, if you have a Hono adapter, you can throw out the Node.js server and replace it with Hono, and it's gonna work. And that's the cool thing about it. It's all gonna work. Alright, now we're done with the example, and let's go back to the documentation and continue to understand the other two parts. So the server framework part. So the important thing to understand here is this happens in this section. So when a request comes to the server, the adapter is gonna give it to Remix, and this is where the magic happens. So the Remix is gonna pass this to either loader or action functions, and they're gonna execute something, prepare a response, and then Remix is gonna give that to the adapter, and the adapter is gonna respond to that. And that's the cool thing about it, is that inside of the loaders and actions, you can basically do whatever you want. The loaders are the equivalent of your GET requests, so this is where you should get the data to be shown to the user. And actions are the equivalent of POST requests, but these can be anything, the verb doesn't matter. All requests that are not GET requests send in the action, so that's the important part. And what happens is, this gets called, and Remix then gives this data to the use loader data hook here. And whenever an action is hit and something is returned to the page, it's given to the use action data hook. So the cool thing about it is that Remix is UI centered. And what this means is, if we go to the next example, this is on their landing page, and this is a great example of why it's UI centered. So if you look at this here, what's gonna happen is each route URL here is gonna have a part of the UI related to it. And each of these have a loader that fire in parallel. So what happens is sales, invoices, and invoice ID all fire loaders at the same time, which allows us to basically speed up the fetching process because they all run in parallel. And the cool thing about it is that every part of the UI is related to a URL segment. And if you look at this example here, this is the best representation of what I'm talking about. The root component has a root loader, and this is gonna fetch some information for us. The sales URL also has a loader, it fetches the sales. The invoices also has a loader, it fetches the invoices. And then this specific invoice ID segment also uses its loader to fetch the invoice part. And the best part about this is that all of these are segmented. And what that means is basically that if you fetch the root, if you fetch the sales, and if you fetch the invoices, all of them are gonna be chunked into smaller pieces, which means that if you're fetching an invoice ID page, and if you navigate to a different invoice ID, the only part that's gonna refetch and change is the invoice ID part. And this brings us back to the browser framework part. So the important thing to note here is that if you're on invoices/1 and if you navigate to invoices/2, what Remix does behind the scenes, it says, okay, I have the whole document here. I only need to change this part of the UI. I'm gonna only refetch the data for that part and render it here. And this differs from the usual old approach where you would have to fetch a document request every time when the URL changes. Remix only refetches the parts it needs to show you the new reflected state of your application. So if you're looking at a page and the page has a bunch of smaller subsections, The only subsections that change when you navigate through them are the ones that need to change. And Remix is smart enough to know what needs to change. So this is the final part that makes Remix great, is that it emulates the browser and adds a bunch of optimizations for you on top of what already exists. So another example of this is if you want to go to expenses here, when you hover over it, you're gonna click on it and we can tell Remix fetch everything on the expenses page in advance, so even on slow internet connections you're firing requests even before you click this item, which allows the browser to fetch everything it needs even before you go to the page. And there's a bunch of other optimizations they do which you can find in the browser framework part of the documentation. It goes pretty deep into what they do, so I recommend you go through this as well. The important thing to take away from this is that Remix is extremely flexible in terms of servers. It can be run anywhere. It's great for browsers because it optimizes a lot of things for you to make the requests as small as possible, and it elevates the DX to a whole different level.
And that's our brief technical overview of what Remix is, how it works behind the scenes, and why I love it so much. If you enjoyed this kind of videos, consider subscribing, because I'll be uploading a ton of more Remix content in the near future. Thank you again, and see you in the next one. Bye!